welcome to Astra Podcast Bonus, an extra episode in between regular episodes where we will relax and let loose our imagination, a listening experience better enjoyed with headphones or a good sound system. I have these interesting theories that I want to share with you today. Maybe these theories were thought of by someone else already, but I'm not really sure. I have two theories about sound, or rather, waves. The first one is that absolute silence is actually all sounds happening at the same time. All sounds that can possibly exist. They sound at the same time continuously, but it cancels out. All the positive phased waves will cancel out with the negatively phased waves, resulting in zero. Or absolute silence. The only way to create a sound in the physical reality would be with a consciousness that will collapse all possible ways sound can exist into one manifested possibility. And thus, a sound is picked from the infinite possibilities. And it's manifested. We are talking about sounds which needs a medium to propagate, like air or other gas, water, or a solid. But even in space, there are different types of waves. The universe is all made of frequencies, and the same principle can apply. Another theory of mine regarding waves and sounds is about music, and how we enjoy music with these organized sound patterns, frequency scales, and melodies. Music can help us enter in a trance state, focus, or get really excited and happy, or sad and thoughtful. All we need is one or more musical instruments and a musician to play it, or a technological device that will play back the recording. The speakers will output the sound waves to our ears, generating the same reactions. And my question slash theory is, what about if we could create a device that can generate brain waves? The same way our brains generate gamma, beta, alpha, theta, and delta waves. What if we could induce back to the brain some kind of music in the same frequencies? Nikola Tesla once said, quote, "If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration." Unquote. And I believe this guy, after all, he's responsible for most of the major technological advances in terms of electricity and power distribution around the world, as well as being one of the pioneers of wireless signals. Energy, frequency, and vibration.
Energy, frequency, vibration.
Everything is frequency. Everything vibrates. Everything is alive.
Energy, frequency, and vibration.
Everything is frequency.
Sound waves are examples of mechanical waves, while light waves are examples of electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves are created by the vibration of an electric charge. This vibration creates a wave which has both an electric and a magnetic component.
Sound waves are examples of mechanical waves. He's repeating himself. It's a cycle. Over here.
Electromagnetic waves are created by the vibration of
sine wave. Waves.
Waves. Has both an electric and a magnetic component.
I've had this idea of the brain waves for quite some time already, and I remember telling this to other people but never shared it publicly. The idea makes sense and seems logical. The same way, when you use a spoon to hit a glass, it will vibrate at a specific frequency. The glass will produce the sound, but if you do it the other way around and you use a speaker to produce the sound, directing it towards the glass will resonate with that sound, vibrating the same way it did when you hit it with a spoon. If you amplify the sound enough, it will make the glass break. What if this technology of a device that can send waves to our brains already exists? Our brains work with tiny electric signals. These signals are the brain waves that I mentioned before. All it would take then is something like a cellular tower that can generate a signal that resonates with the frequency of our brains. And I don't want to go into that direction, but while I was recording this episode, a synchronicity happened. A friend of mine, who by the way doesn't know yet that I'm making this podcast, let alone this particular topic, shared with me a post about a former DARPA scientist who claims that electromagnetic torture and harassment is being used on citizens illegally. This man is called Dr. Paul Batko, and the technology he's talking about is called synthetic telepathy. Now, I don't know whether that's true or not, but I've heard this kind of allegations before, especially with the 5G towers. In my humble opinion, 5G frequency is way higher than the frequencies of our brain, but they say that these frequencies are harmful in other ways. In any case, I think there is a technology that can do this, and they are already using it. I'm pretty sure it's not the 5G. But after my friend shared with me that small article, I instantly knew that I had to add that to this episode. Because if you think about it, if you want to, it makes sense. What if that's already happening, and instead of getting a delightful brainwave music, we're getting another kind of subliminal message directly through our brains with harmful purposes? This next section of the episode is completely unscripted. I don't know, guys, there is a lot of information out there with conspiracy theories and conspiracies, real conspiracies, but what we have to focus on is living life. We are here with this gift of being alive here and now and being able to share with one another, and that's what's really important. It's, you know, having experiences with other people, sharing it, and growing together. That's what really matters. Everything else is just a circumstance, and it doesn't matter what happens around you. What matters is what you do, how you perceive it, and what you do to change it, or what you do to act on it, you know? That's what really matters. Now, if you are in a negative attitude, you will always see everything as attacking you or a negative thing. But if you are a positive person and you are always seeking, you know, learning, you will see it as an opportunity to learn and grow. You know, like going to the gym. You don't go to the gym and complain, oh, this thing is really heavy. What the fuck is going on here? I don't want to get tired. No, you go to the gym to grow your muscles, you know, and get strong. So that's mainly what you do in the gym. So you have to beat yourself up to, you know, to grow your muscles and be stronger and better somehow. So that's what you do. That's what happened. That's a good analogy of life. So talking about, you know, what's the best approach to take on life, you know, how you should live your life. Well, there is plenty of opinions and all of them are right. For instance, we have someone who could say, well, life is studying, getting a great degree so you can get a good job, then get a lot of money so you could buy a house, the best car, and all the best things so you don't have to worry about paying your bills because you will have a lot of money and all of that, and so on. And that's great. That's a great point of view. I love good things, big house, great car. The question is, do you need, you know, like a really big car? Do you really need an extremely huge house? Are you going to occupy all the spaces of the house? Are you going to use them for something? Do you really need those spaces? You know, there is plenty of questions that you have to ask yourself. But yes, everybody loves having a great house, a great car, and not having to worry about paying bills, especially that part. That one is really something. The rest, well, it's just luxury stuff. But it is okay. Yeah, it's a great point of view. But then there is another guy who will say, oh, no. I would prefer to go to the mountains and live in, you know, in a tree house, you know, close to nature and things like that. And that's also great. That's perfect. Now, both lifestyles, both ways of living life are correct, you know? Now, one of them, you know, could be a little bit more selfish than the other, and yeah, that's where you can start thinking about it a little bit. But both ways are right. What's wrong is when you ask one of them, and he or she will tell you, well, my way of living is better than the other way of living because I'm right. The other way of living is wrong. Well, I don't agree with that. Now, it is debatable because, of course, there are some details about each way of life. But let's say that both are correct in the most part. And what I'm saying is, like, let's say I don't want the most expensive car because it's too much, I don't need it, or the biggest house, but I want a big enough house, you know, because I want to have my space, you know, cool space and everything. But the rest, I don't need it. I don't need expensive clothing, expensive jewelry, especially that one, because they don't have a purpose for me anyways. But for other people, it might. So you have to look at those things, you know? And there is a lot of possibilities. There is infinite possibilities. So you have to take advantage of the infinite possibilities and choose one of them. But it's up to you which one you choose. Well, I think this is enough for now. I think I did great. It's just the 10th time I record this. The previous ones, I didn't like them. Anyways, I think I'm not very good at explaining things sometimes. This is my first unscripted part of the podcast, but I hope you have enjoyed it. Remember that if you want to connect with us or the community in general, to provide your own ideas, questions, or whatever you want, you can visit astrapodcast.com. All the nature field recordings were made by me. Also, a minority of sound effects and studio music were produced by me, and the majority of the music was licensed through artlist.io. More information, again, can be found at astrapodcast.com. Thanks for listening, and thank you for existing.